perception is a very important means of knowledge. Now, today we are going to study the art and science of perception. You must also know, let me tell you some fundamental facts about perception before we actually go into the perceptive process. There is external perception, isn't it? You get knowledge by external perception. There is also internal perception. This is something maybe you have not thought about, but your entire mind activity, it is internal perception, isn't it? You are not using your senses there. But what has been recorded through the senses has become your memory, and you are perceiving through your memory. You are knowing something through ideation, mentation and memory. So there is internal perception also. There is something beyond this information also, which is also called perception, which we will go into gradually. So there is external perception and internal perception. Now, external perception, you have ways to enhance it, to augment it. The simple spectacles that you are wearing, that is a means to enhance your perception, isn't it? Your visual perception is being enhanced by your glasses, reading glasses. So also any gadget which the human being has invented, please see this. It is meant to augment the perception of your senses. Your telescopes and microscopes, the Hubble Space Telescope which you have installed there. It is giving you a part of the universe which you cannot see. So it is actually augmenting your visual perception. What you cannot see, it is helping you see. Every gadget is like that. It is helping you see something more than what you can see. So this, since this is our primary means of knowledge, perception, we have invented gadgets, we have discovered ways of augmenting this perception. So also internal perception can be augmented. Your awareness can be increased, brought into full bloom. And your mentation, the capacity of your mind can be increased. You know, the way to realize this, what self-knowledge we have been discussing about, according to the Upanishads, it is to be known through a very refined, enhanced intellect. Drishyate Tvagraya Buddhaya Sukshmaya Sukshmadarshibhi. So there, this very refined intellect, dhi, has become one of the instruments of perception. Like that, your awareness can be cultured. Not that exactly your awareness is being cultured, but the overactive mind is being brought under control so that the volume of awareness in your mind increases. Awareness is always the same, but mind activity can obscure that awareness. So if you clear the mind, awareness level increases. So these are all techniques, methods, just like how you can augment external perception. You can also augment through yogic techniques internal perception. You can develop a separate faculty called the dhi. In the Vedanta, this is what is used. To know Vedantic truth, you need to have a very special kind of buddhi which is turned inward, which is very much enhanced awareness wise and which is refined so that it leads you directly to the truth. This is what is called dhi. Aap jab Gayatri repeat karte ho, the word dhi comes there, isn't it? Dhiyo yona. They are asking for, it's a prayer for getting this higher intellect, this luminous buddhi, which will take you to the source of your perception, the source of your perceptive process, which is the seat of your experience, consciousness. It will awaken that higher consciousness in you. It is a prayer for that. So you see, just as you have methods to enhance external perception, you have means to enhance internal perception. Now, one more thing which you should know about perception is, perception requires mindfulness. If your mind is not in place, there can be no perception, even if you are actually looking at an object. For example, just now you are hearing this lecture and you will be seeing a slide after some time. You may be looking at the slide, but if your mind is not there, you are looking but you are not seeing. Seeing becomes looking becomes seeing when mind is there, when you are mindful. If your mind is somewhere else, it is preoccupied with a movie which you have been seeing, then you are not able, you are not going to get your perception. You are not going to get the information, isn't it? So mind is required for the perceptive process. Please see this point by point. I'm telling you what exactly is required for perception to be successful. If mind is elsewhere, you are looking, but there is no seeing. So also with your other senses. So mindfulness is an essential aspect of the perceptive process.